Hello children, today we will study lesson 4, Nutrition in Plants and Animals. Now, what is nutrition? Children, nutrition is the process of taking food by an organism. What we do is we eat food, okay, in its complex form. Then it gets digested in our body, it gets absorbed, and finally it is oxidized and then utilized by the body. So all the processes together, if we consider them, then that is nutrition. Okay, so the taking in of food and then its digestion, absorption and utilization by the body. Now organisms differ from each other in their modes of nutrition. Some organisms can prepare their own food, while others, they depend on plants or animals for food. So on the basis of mode of nutrition, living organisms are of two types: autotrophic and heterotrophic. See children, autotrophic nutrition. If I break this word autotrophic, auto means self and trophos means nutrition. So autotrophic means self nutrition. Okay, this mode of nutrition means in which the living organism can produce its own food. So the example is green plants, because they can do photosynthesis and they can utilize carbon dioxide and water and convert them into organic substance. Okay, so what is autotrophic nutrition? It means producing organic nutrients from inorganic substances, and green plants have the ability to do so. Then the second mode of nutrition is heterotrophic nutrition. Hetero means other, again trophic means nutrition. So when an organism is depending on others for nutrition, okay, so that is heterotrophic mode of nutrition. So all the animals, they fall under this category. Now depending upon what an animal eats, again heterotrophs can be further categorized, that we will see. Before that, as I told you, green plants, they are the examples of autotrophs. So plants, they take inorganic compounds, that is carbon dioxide and water, and then in the presence of sunlight they can convert it into organic food compound. Okay, so this is your basic photosynthesis. Now as I told you that living organisms, especially animals, they depend on different animals, depend on different sources of food. So depending on that, some animals are herbivores, means they will eat only green plants or plant products. Some are carnivores, they eat flesh of other animals. And omnivores, they eat both plant products as well as animals. You all know the examples as well. You've studied this in your previous class. Now, one thing that you have to remember is herbivores are also known as primary consumers. Carnivores are also known as secondary consumers. Okay? Apart from these three categories, we have two more. Scavengers. Children, scavenge means to clean. Okay, so scavengers are those organisms that feed on dead remains of animals that are killed by predators. So the dead bodies, the dead animals, okay, those and the dead plants, they are all cleaned. They are converted into simpler forms and then digested by some organisms. So they are known as scavengers. Examples: kite and vulture. You all know that kite and vulture, they eat all the dead bodies, okay, the dead remains of animals. Then decomposers. Decompose means to convert something complex into simple. So decomposers are those organisms that can decompose the dead bodies and excreta, plant and animal excreta. Okay, so they obtain their food from these things. Examples are bacteria and fungi. They are examples of decomposers. Alright, so we studied five different types of heterotrophs: herbivores, carnivores, omnivores, scavengers and decomposers. You should know examples of each. That is very important. Now children, moving on to components of food. This chapter is on nutrition, so we should know that what are the different components of food that we need to eat to lead a healthy life. So what are nutrients? Nutrients are those substances that an organism needs for normal growth, repair and maintenance. So there are all these components together, they are the nutrients. So what are the components that we should consume? Carbohydrates, proteins, fat, vitamin, mineral, water, and roughage as well, children. Roughage, that is the dietary fiber, it should also be included. Okay, although it does not provide any energy to the body, it does not participate in bodybuilding, but still it should be a part of our diet. And I will tell you that what is the importance of roughage in our diet. Okay, so if you are asked, you should tell that there are seven different components that must be consumed: carbohydrates, proteins, fat, vitamin, mineral, roughage and water. Now carbohydrates, children, you've studied about carbohydrates in your previous class. Carbohydrates are energy giving food. Okay, and now one new thing that you will study is that carbohydrates are of two types: simple sugar and starch. So the table sugar that you consume, that we eat in desserts, in sweets, that is added, okay, that is an example of simple sugar. Okay, the table sugar, that is the sucrose. Then apart from that, honey has fructose. So glucose, fructose, sucrose, they are all simple sugars. They are generally sweet in taste. The second type of carbohydrate is complex carbohydrate, that is starch. Now starch is generally in the form of white powder. It is tasteless and it is odorless as well. Wheat, rice, maize, bajra, these things we consume, so they all have complex carbohydrate in them. Okay children, when you eat a meal, you all must have noticed that the maximum portion is of carbohydrate. We eat chapati or rice and that covers major portion of our meal, right? So now you know why, because it is a complex carbohydrate and it is the source of energy, the main source of energy in our meal. Okay, next is proteins. Now proteins are bodybuilding food. They are needed for growth and repair, and people who do a lot of physical activity like an athlete or a rickshaw puller, okay, they need a lot of protein. Alright, plus they also need a lot of carbohydrate because they need a lot of energy. Then children of your age, that is growing age, and people with special needs, like if there is a pregnant woman, then you all need a lot of protein in your diet. Alright, so these things I believe that you already have studied. It was just a revision. Now new thing that you will learn today, that is the building block of protein is amino acid. There are 20 different types of amino acids present, and some of them will combine with each other to form a special type of protein. Okay, so all the proteins, they are nothing but different combinations of those 20 amino acids. Amino acids contain carbon, nitrogen, hydrogen, oxygen, and some of them have sulfur and phosphorus as well. Alright children, now talking about how much protein should be there in our diet. A normal adult should consume 1 gram per kg of body weight of protein. So if a person is of 45 kg, then every day that person should consume 45 grams of protein. But growing children and pregnant women, they need more. 1.8 gram of protein per kg of body weight. So a little more protein is required by growing children and a pregnant woman. Children, before moving ahead, I just want you all to see your textbook as well. There is a box. Do you know box on page number 49? There it is mentioned that our muscles, they are made up of proteins, then our skin, hair, nails, okay, they all have proteins in them. Then in our digestive system and all the systems that are there in our body, you know, there are different types of enzymes that are involved in all the reactions that are taking place. So those enzymes, they are all proteins, okay, and our blood is red in color because of the presence of hemoglobin in the RBCs. So again, hemoglobin, so globin is also a protein, okay. So these are all different types of proteins. When I say that all the types of proteins, then this thing should come to your mind that our nails, hair, skin, muscles, enzymes, these are all different types of proteins. All right. The next component is fat. Children, fat also gives us energy, okay, and it is a complex molecule. It is made up of fatty acid and glycerol. So if I ask you that proteins are made of dash, you will write amino acids. If I write fats are made of, the answer will be fatty acids and glycerol, okay. Now, although fat is also energy giving food, but we say that we should consume fat in moderation, and we can eat more carbohydrate, but fats should not be consumed in very good quantities, okay, because it is harmful. Why we say so? When it is written that it is an energy giving food, because fat is difficult to digest. It is a slow source of energy. And if we continue to consume excess fat, then what will happen? It will get stored in the body. This may lead to extreme fatness, that is obesity. And it can also increase the level of cholesterol in the blood vessels. If cholesterol deposition begins in the blood vessel, then it will affect the flow of blood. Okay? And because of this, a person might suffer from high blood pressure or different types of heart disorders. So we don't want that. That is why it is said that fats should be consumed in moderation. Children, next component is vitamin. Now they are the protective foods that are needed in very small quantity. They do not give us energy, they do not help in bodybuilding, but for the normal functioning of body, for normal growth, for good vision, healthy teeth, gums, bones, for all these reasons, we need vitamins, okay? Now, this is something that you already knew. What you are about to learn is that vitamins can also be categorized into two types. Some of them are soluble in water, while others are soluble in fat. So, vitamin B and C are water soluble. A, D, E, K are fat soluble. Alright, there is a table in your book on page number 50 based on vitamin sources and its main functions, and if there is a deficiency of a particular vitamin, then what disease a person can suffer from, the deficiency disease. So these four categories are there, and this table is there. Children, I want you all to just go through that table. Alright, it is a very important table. You should know that what are the different sources, functions and deficiency diseases associated with all the vitamins. So please go through that table. Alright, children. Then one more thing, the sources of these components. Children, you already know, and when we will be studying about balanced diet, then once again I will be telling you about the sources. Now you know that fat, if I talk about fat, so fat we get from plant sources as well as animal source, okay, like your soybean oil, sunflower oil, mustard oil, they are all plant sources. And your animal sources are all the dairy products, they are all animal sources of fat, okay. Then talking about proteins, again there are plant as well as animal sources of protein. So if you take your lentils and beans, soybean, peas, they are all plant sources of protein. And the dairy products like paneer, then your milk, then meat, egg, they are all animal sources of protein, okay. So, and carbohydrates we get from all the sweet fruits, then we get it from, as I told you, wheat, rice, bajra, then your potato, they are all good sources of carbohydrates, okay. So, the relevant pictures are there in your book, plus you have a fair idea about the sources. Still we will be discussing it when we will study about balanced diet, okay. So I want you all to revise till the portion that I've covered today. Thank you, children.